Okay, so today I'm going to give you a couple of tips and exercises you can do to build up your picking speed. So first one is just doing all downstrokes as fast as you can for 1 minute straight. You want to do that for a whole minute, okay? I know I cut it really short. I did like maybe 10 seconds or 15 seconds, but you want to do that for a whole minute as fast as you can, flat out for 1 minute straight, okay? As fast as you can. I see people doing this. I'm like, no, that's not going to get you anywhere. You got to do it for a whole minute. And at top speed. Top speed you can do it at. Okay, and once you're done with that, then you want to do all upstrokes as fast as you can for 1 minute as well. Okay, so once you do that, your arm is probably going to be a little tight, a little wiped out from that. Good. Now we can start working on some triplets after that. You want to make them as tight as you can. By doing that, you're just going to mute in between each triplet set. Now, what you're going to notice, especially after doing this, is that you're going to have a hard time really keeping up those triplets because you're already getting some muscle fatigue. That's a good thing. You want to keep that going. And if you get bored with just doing that, you can just start moving the notes around. It doesn't really matter. Whatever. So do that and try to push through. Once, and with that one, I wouldn't necessarily time that one. It's not like a minute long. Just do it you get to a point where your arm gets really, you start feeling it in here, gets really tired, okay? And you want to push past that point. You don't want to just do it and say, okay, I'm feeling it now, I'm done. No, you want to push it. You got to push past that. Okay, this is a real exercise. Think about it. If you go to the gym to work out, you don't just like find some weights, go, okay, these are a little heavy, I'll just do like two or three and I'm done. No, 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 no. You got to sit there and really work on it and push past that comfort zone, okay? And that's what we're doing here, is after you do this and this, now we're just going to add the triplets in and we're going to push past that comfort zone that you're in. Okay, and then what we're going to do is then do quads, right? Quads, whatever, but it's just a group of four instead of a group of three, right? So then it's more like, okay, so then just work on stuff like that. And then what you want to do is you want to start doing some all downstroke things, but then go string to string. All right, so that way you can actually do all this. Now what I'm doing is I'm playing the open E palm muted. Then I go to 7th fret on the high E, on the A string. Then I'm going to the D string, but I'm doing the 8th fret here. And then the 9th fret on the G string. That's what I'm doing there, buddy. And that's going to help you get down your string skipping abilities as well. And this is after you've already done all the other stuff. You have a lot of arm fatigue going on. Okay, so that would be a really good exercise to help with that. All right, this is all to help get your picking for playing metal up to a very, very high standard. That's what you want, right? That's what we're going for here. So, plus I think it sounds pretty badass. Now you can turn that into a riff or something. All right, so that's just a few tips I'm giving you for now. All right, well, check in with me next time. I'm gonna have some more metal tips for you. All right, thanks for watching.